For today's police report, two die in action versus rogue policemen. Believed to be dealing in illegal drugs resulted in the killing of two persons. From Ontowa Township, New Jersey, a drunk driving dad crashes car, kills infant daughter. State police say father was driving drunk on a suspended license when he crashed on a southern New Jersey highway, killing his infant daughter. For our sports news today, Molto Toa and Christian Stan Hardinger will be trading places. Local sports news, Olympics bound Yulo wins historic gold for Philippines in World Championships. For our showbiz updates today, two rumored actors cheating. University of Mindanao enrollment updates.
Live from CBS 202 studio with your news anchor, Pai Dinopo. Good evening, Philippines. I'm very glad to be with you tonight, and this is Pai from CBS 202. Two die in action versus rogue policeman in Barangay Bangbang, Cordova, Cebu City. And drunk driving, dad crashes car, kills infant daughter. Mike King reporting.
Looking for a tasty and Instagrammable? And are you planning to visit Japan? No matter when you visit Asakusa, it's most definitely bustling with people.
Illegal drugs resulted in the killing of two persons in Cordova, town of Cebu. Police Captain Diaz said a surveillance was being conducted following reports that Pacaliago, the rogue police, was sighted in the residence of a certain Arvet Arbilot in Barangay Bangbang, Cordova.
a police operation to build up a case against a rogue policeman believed to be dealing in illegal drugs resulted in the killing of two persons in Cordova, town of Cebu. Police Captain Diaz said a surveillance was being conducted following reports that Pacaliago, the rogue police, was sighted in the residence of a certain Arvet Arvilon in Barangay Bangbang, Cordova. Pacaliago, Arvilon, and four others were having a pot session in a secluded area meters away from Arvilon's house when Cordova police arrived in the area, as Diaz said. Unfamiliarity in the area causing the Cordova police to lose Pacaliago and other suspects. Pacaliago is a high-value target in provincial level when he went AWO because he was on the drugs watch list. Arvilon, on the other hand, is a high-value target in municipal level. Police Lieutenant Colonel Conag appealed to the residence corporation to give whereabouts of Pacaliago. Arrested were George Macan, brother of the deceased Macan, and Jerlyn Perosilio, both admitted that they took part in the past session but denied having any affiliation with Pacaliago.
A drunk driver from New Jersey driving under influence of alcohol with an infant by the name of Leroy Iglesias is facing a serious crime of vehicular homicide and child endangerment.
Jersey, driving under influence of alcohol with an infant by the name of Leroy Iglesias, is facing a serious crime of vehicular homicide and child endangerment. According to the police report, he was driving a minivan in a southbound area in New Jersey on Route 55 when the accident happened. The vehicle he was driving ran off the right side of the road and struck two trees around 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and inside of his van was his infant daughter. His infant daughter did not survive the crash due to multiple injuries, and the authorities are claiming that the daughter might have not properly buckled on her car seat. Gladly, there were no other car collisions, and that might have been more serious problems he will be facing on. The authorities are still investigating further of the incident.
Back to you, bye.
Sports today, Molto Tawa and Christian Stan Hardinger are trading places. And Olympic-bound Yolo wins historic gold medal for PHN World Champions. Steven will give us an update.
Thank you, Pai. For sports updates, Molto Tawa and Christian Stan Hardinger trade places. As the Northport and San Miguel Brewing agree to a deal involving two big men. The Brewing will receive the top overall pick of 2015 and will draft Molto Tawa. The 30-year-old Filipino Toman is averaging 11.3 points, 8.8 rebounds, and 2.3 assists per game in the ongoing PBA Governor's Cup. While the Northport Batavier will receive the first overall pick of 2017, a 6'8 Filipino-German center, considered as one of the promising PBA superstars in these days. Now let's go to gymnastics. Olympic-bound Yulo wins historic gold medal for the Philippines in the World Championship. Carlos Idril Yulo ruled the floor exercise final and gave the country its first ever gold medal in the 49th FIG Artistic Gymnastic World Championship. The 19-year-old Yulo automatically qualified for the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. That's all for the sports updates. Back to you, Pai.
Thank you, Steven. CBS 202 will be right back after the break.
That I could chase you with a cold evening. Let a couple years water down how I'm feeling about you.
I wanna hold you when I'm not supposed to. When I'm lying close to someone else, you're in my head and I can get you out of it. I could do it all again.
I know I'd go back to you.
I'll go back.
beautiful. Pantene.
I'll take a Coke.
Is Pepsi okay?
Is Pepsi okay? Is Pepsi okay? Ow! Our puppy's okay. Is a shooting star okay?
Is the laughter of a small child okay?
Are you with me? You seem confused. Let's role play. Now.
Okay, I'm Steve. I'm an actor.
No. Just order something.
You
will have a nice cold glass of the best thing you ever tasted. Okay?
Okay.
I think you might be just saying it wrong. You gotta say it with pride, okay?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, kind of. Pepsi's more than okay. It's okay! Okay! Okay, what have we learned today?
You want a Pepsi?
I want a Pepsi.
She wants a Pepsi. There you go. Okay. Like Little John. Okay. I've got to come up with my own catchphrase. Okay.
For our showbiz updates, two rumored actors cheating. And Matt will give us an inside news.
According to an avid fan who posted the picture in Instagram, Gerald and Julia was caught dating, bringing them is their stats. People are now talking about this hottest issue. What would be the reaction of Bea Alonzo? We are all been waiting for her response. On the other side, university update. Enrollment for second semester for school year 2019 and 2020 is now open. Dates are shown in the screen. November 4, 2019 will be the start of the class. This is Matt, your Surf Patroller of the Night. Back to you, Pai.
Thank you, Matt. And now if you're looking for tasty and Instagrammable, we have 5 popular Asakusa ice cream shops in Japan.
Time to visit Japan, these are the 5 popular Asakusa ice cream shops you must visit. Ice Tokyo, a 3-minute walk away from Tokyo Metro Asakusa Station, its specialty is ice cream roll. In the shop, there's a giant teddy bear waiting for you. You can take pictures with the bear after you have ordered your ice cream, making it a great picture for posting on social media. Next is Suzuken. The most popular flavor is Matcha Premium No. 7. Third one is the Funawa Nakamise, which is vanilla spot ice cream. Then the fourth one is Yamatuya Shop, then the Fruits Parlor Goto. Back to you, bye!
Or extension of Typhoon Hagibis affects southern Mindanao. Ram will give us an update.
The northeasterly surface wind flow affects the country, which will give a cold or hot weather except those areas that are affected with a trough or extension of Typhoon Hagibis. Because of the indirect heat of the typhoon, hoping light rains will pour on the south of Mindanao.
Thank you so much, Ram. This is CBS 202. Have a great night.